casting directors and directors and everybody have been very, I mean, I've always been tested for good projects overall. But on the set, I realized that I'm actually standing behind the main protagonist of the TV commercial, along with four other people. The ad came and I was not even visible in the ad, honestly. All the actors that I've worked with, I've learned a lot from them. You know, I've done TV commercials with Mr. Shah Rukh Khan and Madhuri Dixit.
Hello everyone, welcome to our show Success Stories Season 2. Talk show presented by Trident Communication in association with World Humanitarian Foundation. I'm Sneha, your host for today, and our guest for today is Jitin Gulati. Jitin, he's an actor. You might have seen him in hundreds of commercials. MS Dhoni, Inside Edge, Broken, and Shatrusal are few of the names in which he had worked. So now let us talk about his journey to success. Jitin, a very warm welcome to our show today.
I'm very well, Sneha. Thank you so much for having me here. And I hope that all of you and your team members are doing well.
A very warm welcome to our show. And thank you so much for joining us today. So we'll start with the questions.
Oh, please.
Jitin, you started your career, professional career in HSBC Bank for 8 long years. So what make you to switch your career from that profession to the entertainment industry?
So I was a commerce student in Hansraj College, Delhi University. And I always wanted to be an actor. It just so happens that, you know, when you're from Delhi and you're away from Bombay, you really don't know how to make a living out of this world. None of my family members, dur dur ke bhi koi log, you know, have never been on a film set. I really did not know how to go about things. And I just did not wanted to leave everything and then come here. I wanted to prepare and train myself and then come here. So after my college, I got my job with HSBC Bank. I actually joined the job thinking that I'm going to be working for 1 year, maximum 2 years, you know, collect enough money to get a portfolio done and eventually move to Bombay. But, you know, I think life has its plans and some things happen at the right time, you know, and there's always a place and time for everything, I guess. So I was there for 8 years, doing well in the bank, but then it came a point where I had to choose where I need to jump in right now. Otherwise, you know, this dream will only remain a dream. So I quit after 8 years of working. I actually got moved to Bombay as a promotion. And I think that's just facilitated my whole movement to this world. Because once you come to Bombay, then you figure out what all possibilities are there and how I can make a living out of this world. And I think that's what happened when I moved to Bombay eventually.
Okay. Jitin, switching a career, like banking is supposed to be a stable profession and acting is a quite unstable thing. So how did you convince your parents? Like, were they happy with your decision?
No, I think they're always happy with when I'm happy, but it's, of course, parents want good for you, right? I mean, they would not want you to put towards something which is so difficult. Where you don't know anybody, where the risk is so high, where you could be working for 10 years, but still you might not reach anywhere. You know, in any other profession, what happens is that if you've spent a certain amount of time in that world, you do get promoted. You know, you do have a job security. Some stability comes in your life. In acting per se, you could be working hard for 10 years here and you still might not get anywhere. You know?
Yes.
So they were concerned, of course, and I was leaving a bank job and I was at a good position. I had got a few promotions, you know, in 8 years and I was at a good position. So leaving that particular job at that position where I was always also being looked at for an international placement. I mean, for me, it was a very easy decision, honestly, because I was very clear this what I want to do with my life. But so my family was... It was a difficult decision for them to, you know, accept in the beginning. But I think once they saw why am I into it and it's just not, you know, for fame or just luck with me, they were always very supportive. And that's what they've been. I mean, for the last 10, 12 years that I've been doing this, I have been able to survive largely because I have that, you know, I have a strong support from my family.
So this entertainment industry, you started your career as a modeling, as a model. Yeah. So how much struggle did you face in getting that first assignment of yours?
It's actually a very funny story. I was so excited about doing this that I never looked at it like a struggle. So there was a point in time that I was working in the bank and I was finishing my work at 6 o'clock and I would go out and audition from 7 to 11 every day, you know, okay. for other projects. And I was just enjoying it so much. It was like, you know, when fish takes to water. So for me, honestly, it was not struggle. I mean, I think people from the outside will see it as a struggle because they don't know how much I'm enjoying the process. Sorry, the process of auditioning or getting some job. But for me, it was, you know, I was so energized, you know, in the evenings once I was done with my banking job and doing all those auditions. So I didn't see that as struggle. I got my first TV commercial. And, you know, I'm not even visible in that TV commercial, honestly, but I was just so happy to be on the set. It was a TV commercial for Forbes magazine. Forbes magazine was launching at that point of time in India. And I tested for it and it was a long audition. So I assumed that it's a good part. But on the set, I realized that I'm actually standing behind the main protagonist of the TV commercial, along with four other people. The ad came and I was not even visible in the ad. Honestly, but I was happy being on the set that nothing else mattered to me.
Yes. So you never regretted that you left the job, a stable job, and you are into this field?
No. I'm quite certain about, I'm not very certain about a lot of things, you know, otherwise, but the one certainty I have in my life is that I want to do this. I mean, I'm a very firm believer of you should be able to spend your life the way you want to. Because it's a very small life. It's a very, you know, whatever said and done, we might say that life is long, but life actually passes you by very quickly. You never know. And then, you know, one day you're sitting and you're 60 years old. So I'm a very firm believer that you should be able to do whatever you intend to do with your life. So no, I don't regret, not even for a moment, even though this life is way tougher. It's very unstable and there are a lot of ups and downs and, there are some crazy days also, but no, never regretted that.
Because you're enjoying your work.
Yes.
It's your passion. That's why you're not regretting. So your career as an actor, how did the industry treated you?
Look, the industry, casting directors and directors and everybody have been very, I mean, I've always been tested for good projects overall. I got my first film, Warning 3D, which was produced by Anubhav Sinha, Mr. Anubhav Sinha and Eros International, and directed by Gurmeet Singh. It was a good project at that point of time. And I had actually tested for an ad. And I did that ad, and the casting director of that TV commercial was casting for that film. And that's how I got my first film. And the film did not do well commercially. So then, you know, it's very important that you have a commercial success behind you or you are noticed in your first project. That did not really turn out the way one would want it to. So then I had a good 2.5 years of gap where I was not getting much work. I was testing a lot. I was auditioning a lot. I was getting shortlisted. I was signing a lot of things, but nothing was going on the set. And one day, suddenly, then I got a call for MS Dhoni, The Untold Story. And I picked that up because it was Mr. Neeraj Pandey's film. So I've always been tested, you know, but sometimes it's just about the right project coming for you. And I realized that, you know, I did not want to sit and wait for the right project to come my way, you know, for that big project. Mm-hmm. So if a project was good, I mean, let's say out of three aspects, if two aspects were working for me, either the role and the director was good, or the project was big and the director was good, but my role was not that great, or my role was good, the project was good, but it was a new director. Mm-hmm. Out of these three aspects, if two things were working for me, I took up those jobs. And do not wait for that one Friday, you know, which will make me something. And that's how my career has been largely. I've taken up projects, good projects, and on those small parts also, I've been appreciated. And because of the smaller parts, I've got the bigger parts. And so all the dots have joined, and you know, maybe I'll get to the point where I want to be. But overall, it's I have been tested for good. So the industry has been quite welcoming, per se. I've never been seen as somebody who cannot act or somebody, you know, who cannot carry a project. It just so happens that sometimes I think everything needs to come together to get you to that one right project.
So this was all the struggle you went through. And who has been your biggest support in these struggle days?
My family, of course. I mean, my mother, who knows everything that's happening in my life. My father, who's a silent support in my life, but I know he's worrying a lot. And my sisters, they've supported me in every possible way I think somebody can be supported, whether it's financially, emotionally, in every aspect, you know. I think they are my biggest blessing. And I think that's very important, because it's quite a lonely journey when you are trying to make something of yourself in any field, honestly. And I think if you have that support, the support of your source, you know, your family, it really makes things well in the end. It makes things, I won't say easy, but they are bearable, you know, if that support is there.
Yes, family is the biggest support, really. They keep you emotionally and mentally strong.
Oh, yes.
So you have worked in TV serials, Bollywood films, web series. So which of these you enjoyed the most?
I enjoy everything, because the camera does not differentiate when the camera looks at me. The camera does not differentiate that I'm, you know, doing a web series or a film or a TVC. Some of my biggest learning has happened on TV commercials, you know, even though they are for 30 seconds, 1 minute, the kind of precision that's required to do a TV commercial. You learn that a lot. And sometimes that helps in films. In television, my biggest learning was to get comfortable with the camera, because I was shooting 18 hours every day. I was literally sleeping and shooting there only. So television, you know, does that to you. And it's quite a blessing in that sense. It really makes you, if you work hard, it makes you very comfortable with the camera. And of course, I mean, I did Dhoni. That was my first experience of working on a big budget film. You know, sometimes just the idea of being a part of such a big project helps you understand a lot of things. And OTT is offering me a lot of meatier parts, more layered parts, bigger parts. So as an actor, I'm growing a lot. You know, my understanding of projects, my characters, stories, and how to work with the director is largely a derivation of what I'm learning through my OTT work. So I don't differentiate. For me, the camera does not differentiate, and I don't differentiate in any medium.
That's great. So Jatin, what are your future projects coming up?
So my show Chhatrasaal came last week. It just released. I have another show which I shot again in 2019. That should come out this year. Producers are still to announce that. It's called Salt City. Then there's Inside It Season 3, which will come out on Amazon Prime in mostly end of this year, the last quarter. There is a film, a short film that I did with Shabana Ji, Swara Bhaskar and Divya Ji, called Sheer Korma. That will come out next year. And I'm currently shooting for a series for Amazon Prime, which will come out next year end.
So many entertaining things are coming up.
Yeah, I'm quite excited about, you know, the lineup that I have. Yes, I mean, testing for a few other things. There's a lot of good work happening, honestly. There's a lot of good, you know, stories being told right now. People are, because of this whole OTT boom, people are taking, you know, riskier subjects, and actors are getting to really work on good layered characters. So it's quite an exciting time for actors right now.
Jatin, any unforgettable moment of your life you want to share with our viewers?
Unforgettable moment?
Yeah.
There are many. I mean, you're asking about
koi ek aisa moment ya aisa koi event jo aap chahte hain ki hum sab jane, hamare viewers jane.
Jaise suddenly to yaad nahi aayega. I think all the actors that I've worked with, I have learned a lot from them. You know, I have done TV commercials with Mr. Shah Rukh Khan and Madhuri Dixit and Mr. Bachchan. And I worked with Shabana Ji recently. You know, all the actors that as, and I wanted to be an actor since I was a child. So, you know, I've always seen these people and admired and figured what they do and how they, you know, perform. For me, I think watching them up close and personal and sometimes doing a scene with them.
Yes.
Those are really moments that I cherish a lot, you know, because there's some magic that they bring about, and that's why they are what they are. And you just get to learn a lot from them. I think those moments that I've spent with these people, they really mean a lot to me.
So that must be like dream coming true for you, seeing all those personality in front of you or working with them also.
Yeah, and not only actors, you know, every time I've worked with a director that I really wanted to work with, that has also, like, you know, been so much of learning. And as an actor, you always want to work with a certain set of directors. If you get to meet them, if you speak to them, there's just a new dimension that you understand about life itself or stories itself. It is such a fruitful experience to be working with these people, you know. That's my biggest learning in the industry, honestly.
Yes. Our show, Success Story, works with World Humanitarian Foundation, which works for women empowerment. So we would like to know your views regarding the women around the globe.
Sneha, honestly, I'm at a loss of words. I mean, when you say my views on women, I mean, women ideally are people who are running our world. I mean, I am here because of a woman, my mother. So I don't even know if I'm qualified to speak on that topic. But all I can say is that feminism, women empowerment should be everybody's job. I also very firmly believe that we should stop comparing, and we should stop, you know, having that competition between men and women. While we always different, I feel we are unique, and we need to celebrate uniqueness. We need to celebrate uniqueness of men and women, and coexist. I think that'll be true empowerment. The day we actually stop comparing and competing and saying that who is better than who. We are unique, and of course, women are far superior. I mean, I personally believe that. But I still would not want to go into that comparison and, you know, competition space, because we both need each other. It's not possible to have one species, one gender, and not the other. So I think let's celebrate the uniqueness and go for it.
Okay. Jatin, one last question. Our show name is Success Stories. So hum ye janna chahenge ki, what is your definition of success?
I think success for me is being happy in everyday life. Success is not something that I set out to achieve. I can't say that I'll be successful because I'll get something. If I'm happy with what I'm doing today with my life, if I'm able to live my life the way I want to, and I'm telling you, that's a big deal. If I can spend my life doing what I love, being with the people that I love, and learning the things that I want to, I think that is success for me. Because in that case, you know, on that journey, when you're walking on that journey, the destination really means something when you reach there, you know, if there is a destination for that matter. But for me, success is that. I don't know, when people say that your project worked, you are successful. When your project doesn't work, you're not successful. For me, success was the day I started pursuing acting professionally, full-time. And I was really happy about something that I'm doing and I want to be good at. I want to be excellent at, because I love it. And because I was happy, I was able to make other people around me happy. You know, when you're miserable, people around you are miserable. You can actually make them miserable. So it's very, very important, you know, to be able to do something that you want to do with your life. It's a tough thing. And I think everybody has a right to fight for that. And if you can do that, I think that is success for me.
Thank you so much, Jatin. That was very inspiring. And it was our pleasure to have you in our show today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sneha. Thank you so much for having me here. All the very best to you.